All right, I'm going to start by generating a component using Angular CLI. So I open the terminal and type ng-g-c for component and then authors. So this creates a folder called authors with four files, a CSS file, an HTML file, a unit test file, and a TypeScript file. It also registers this component in our app module. So now let's go to this new component. In VS Code, we have a shortcut for navigating to different files. So on Mac, you press Command and P. On Windows, you press Control P. And here you can type the name of a file. So authors.ts. Now here, the first item is our spec or unit test file. The second is the TypeScript class we are looking for. Here, I want to add a field to hold the list of authors, like this. Next, I'm going to generate a service using Angular CLI. So back in the terminal, we can clear this using Control and L. Once again, ng, what should we type here? G, and then what? S for service, and then authors. Okay, we have a new service. Let's close the terminal using Control and backtick. Go to app.module and register this new service as a provider. So Angular can provide that as a dependency while instantiating components. So here's the providers array. I'm going to add authors service. Now let's go to the author service. So command and P, authors.ts. Here's our service. Here we don't need a constructor yet. So I'm going to delete this and instead add a method called getAuthors, which simply returns an array with three authors, author one, author two, and author three. Okay. Now we need to inject this service into the constructor of our new component. So let's go back to our authors component. And by the way, you can use Control and Tab to navigate between the open files in the editor. So let's go to authors.component. Here in the constructor, I'm going to add a parameter, service of type authors service. Okay. And then I'm going to initialize this authors and set it to service.getAuthors. Now the last step, we want to render these authors in our template. So here, this component uses an external template. So instead of template, we have template URL, which is set to the name of a template file relative to this component. So period slash refers to the current folder. Let's go to this file, authors.component.html. So once again, command and P, authors dot. Now you don't have to type the complete file name, like authors.component. You don't have to do that. You can simply type authors.html or auth.html. All right, here we want to delete this template. Instead, we want to add an H2. Now here we want to display the number of authors. So we use string interpolation. We add authors. And because this is an array, we can access the length property. So after that, we can add the authors label. That's one way. Another way is to delete this here and concatenate the author's length with this string here. Now I find the first approach to be cleaner. So let's remove this. Okay. So we displayed the number of authors and then we'll have a UL and inside that we'll have an LI. Now let me show you a quick way to generate this markup. So instead of typing all this, you can type UL and then greater than LI. When you press tab, it generates this markup for you. Okay. Now here you want to use a directive to render a list item for each author. So as you remember, that directive is called ng4. And because it changes the structure of our DOM, we need to prefix it with an asterisk. So asterisk ng4, we set it to an expression, let author, which is a template variable of authors. And inside this list item, we render the author using string interpolation. Author, like this. So we have a new component for displaying the list of authors. Now let's go back to our TypeScript file again. So authors.component.ts. Look at the selector. That's app-authors. When you generate components with Angular CLI, it always prefixes the component selectors with app dash. The reason for this is because it tries to minimize the chance of another component coming from a third-party library clashing with your component. Now, this is a good practice in some ways, but it also adds some extra noise in your code. So I personally prefer to remove this app dash unless I have a strong reason for using it. So delete, make it cleaner. Now we need to use this component in the template for our app component, which is the root component of our application. So command and p app.html. So previously we added the courses element. You're going to delete this and add authors. Save. Now back in the browser. Beautiful. We have three authors. We have the heading as well as a bunch of list items.